Ted, you'll see you now.
Thanks very much, Goofy.
That's okay. It's my job.
Well, good morning, sir.
Ted, sit down. Don't stand there like a statue judging me.
Well, thank you, Mr. Miles. I wasn't judging you, far from it. I think, if anything, you've been judging me and my broadcast.
Okay, first, let's get things straight. There are no broadcasts. Everything, if we work it right, everything is on broadcast TV, cable TV, DVD. I mean, the only thing we don't repurpose 8 ways to sunrise is the surveillance videos of you taking a crap.
Well,
you get my drift here, newsboy? No broadcasts. All there is are shows. Some shows are in a theme park with minimum wage kids wearing big heads. Some shows are on sets in Washington where the anchor is paid more money than Minnie on maternity leave. And he's got big hair. But they're all shows.
All right, sir. Well, I guess we're here to talk about my memo. I wasn't intending to try to threaten this company.
Oh, Theodore, don't try to peddle mouse crap to the mouse. I've been around Goofy Drive a couple of times. Of course you were trying to threaten us. You guys couldn't continue to work unless you had the assurance of a long-term commitment to your show.
Well, I was being metaphorical.
Look, you're being paid more money than the entire cast of The Lion King.
Well,
now get serious. You'll put out that show and do it with commitment and energy if I don't give you any reason to believe it's going to be on the air past Bill Maher's pimp's birthday.
Look, Mr. Mouse.
Call me Mickey. When you say mouse, I don't know. Maybe it's me, but I detect an attitude there as if, I'm the king of TV journalism and I have to report to a frigging rodent. Well, guess what, Murrow Man? You do. It is a small world after all.
All right, Mickey. Let me be absolutely straight with you. We've done excellent shows for you for more than 2 decades.
Only because nobody on the cartoon floor of the building gave a flying frog. You know, every once in a while, Donald would squawk about the animation of his old daytime show on the Disney Channel being cheaper than the opening graphic of your show. But
well, for whatever reason, we got viewers. We made money for this network.
You made money when this place was owned by the Cap Cities people. The Goyim! The humans!
Well, all the same, as broadcasters, they did have a dedication to the importance of news and public service.
Mm-hmm.
And to be truthful, I've never sensed that dedication since...
Since we took over?
Of course. Well, the pursuit of David Letterman while denigrating the value of our show...
See? Now you're saying it. And you're not even wincing.
That pursuit, coupled with branding our program as irrelevant...
Hey, Ted! That's the silliest thing of all. You got your panties all in a bunch when we called you irrelevant. What did you think? That's a put-down? Please, my friend, around here, irrelevant is the best thing you can be. You think we got all those schmoes walking down Main Street thinking, "Ooh, boy, this is going to be relevant"?
Well, sir, it all contributed to a sense that, and pardon me for saying this, Mickey, that you don't really care about news.
Ted, I'm at a level with you, mouse to man.
All right.
You can ask Minnie what's the first thing I do in the morning.
Well, I'm sure you order up a cheese plate of some kind.
Before that, I read the papers, Ted. Look, you won't feel like you're lacking support? Here's what I got on my plate, okay? Besides cheese. Huey, Dewey, and Louie all just got the same agent. I'm going to wind up paying 3 times as much for 3 frigging afterthought ducks. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. I think I do.
You're just lucky you weren't pulling this scam when Walt was around. You'd have ended up doing The Secret Life of Walruses so fast your hair would be spinning.
Mr. Mouse, I don't want to seem as if I've I've come here empty-handed. Mm-hmm. If there's anything we could do to develop the Nightline brand for rides or park attractions.
Oh, sure. The Rwanda famine could work real well. Kind of like a model cafe, only more depressing. Ted, please, get out of my sight before I puke all over my gloves.
Well, sir, I am grateful for this time, and I am not unmindful of the nature of the bargain I've entered into. I just...
You like news? Here's a flash. From our point of view, it's no bargain. And no, we don't validate.
All right, sir. Thank you.
You think you have it tough? Not a day goes by when the boss doesn't make Donald feel like Daffy is the funnier duck.
All right, Goofy, thank you for that much-needed perspective.
That's what they don't pay me for.